So the inspiration for In Between Men is twofold. First, it's an inspiration comes from my personal life, a relationship I had with a guy who has one of the characters is inspired by him. And partly it's also inspired by the gay community itself. I didn't see a lot of myself in the gay community, and I certainly didn't see a lot of myself on TV and film, on the web, and any kind of mainstream media.
If I could give you the world on a silver platter, would it even matter? You'd still be mad at me if I could find you now.
Kendra's backstory has more to do with living in between worlds. You know, I think she's the only woman on the show. And so there are elements of her femininity, and I think that she chooses to kind of squash down, and then there are elements I think that she chooses to bump up. Like, I'm sure, you know, she obviously uses her sex appeal a great deal, but at the same time, you know, she is all business. And I personally,
it's just right. A million words we never say, the way I truly feel about the one I just can't live without. Cause it's like that.
It's just more real. It's more real, and I feel like a lot of people can identify with the show because you're not playing a stereotype. You're playing the person, you know, you work with, the person, you know, your cousin, you know, like, these are real people.
The men that make up In Between Men, it's a very diverse group. You know, you have your execs, you have your artists, and I think they're all over the place in terms of the acceptance, of course, of their sexuality and where they are in regards to their experiences with relationships and kind of, you know, how they function.
I think overall, there should be something for everyone to be able to relate to. We're breaking down barriers as far as what, what's socially acceptable. I mean,
we all live two worlds. We all have split identities. We're all a little bit of this and a little bit of that. And as you'll see, the characters in the show ring true with that as well. It's really about four guys, four friends. They're all successful. They're all in their mid-20s to mid-30s. They're living in New York City. They have good jobs. They make good money. And the world is more or less their oyster. Three of the guys happen to be gay. My character's bisexual, but that's What's really great about this show is that we're not playing to stereotypes. We're talking about real people, real guys, and the fact that they have men as their sexual partners really makes no difference to who they are as people or their position in life, their position in their company.
He is a doctor in the ER, and he's more of the shy type. He's not as outspoken and crazy as some of the other characters are in the show. And I like that. I like more of the shy, withdrawn type. I think I'm gonna relate with Dan a lot. Everyday guys that you would meet on the street, but you wouldn't at first glance know that they were gay. They're like every other guy you would always meet, and you wouldn't have a second thought about it unless they actually told you, I'm gay or bisexual or however. And so I find that very interesting. I don't think that we've had a show like that yet, to where you have this normal front to the way things are, like how you see it every day, your own first perception of how things are, but then you explore the backdrop, you explore the background, you explore behind the scenes of the lives of these men, and so you get to see.
Sexy girl on a plane, why you crying? What's your name? Who you running
it's about
from?
A group of people. More than anything, it's just a group of friends and their adventures as they go through the world of New York.
Time for another voice to be heard kind of on the platform right now.
Great.
And to show some balance. It's all about giving a broad view of the whole LGBT diaspora, which is not what's happening right now. And also entertain you at the same time. The show's racy, it's edgy, it's funny, it has a heart, it's very sexy, everybody's really hot in the show. And diversity is important. So, I mean, all of those themes, I mean, everything that's modern, everything that's 21st century, is what this show is about. So it's time, it's now, it's happening. You need to get on board.
Hey, you need to watch.